Hi, and welcome to my talk on the nullish coalescing operator in JavaScript. This is a new operator that's in ES 2020, so it's relatively new. You'd need Node 14 to get it. It works in most modern browsers. It might not work on Android, Firefox. It might not work on some of the mobile browsers. You might have to use Babel and polyfill it back in to get it, but it's a really neat operator that you can use to deal with values that are either undefined or null. So, what we got here is we got Node.js, a JavaScript REPL, so I can do any kind of JavaScript-y kinds of things. So I could go, here's a lambda that does 2 times I, and then I could say, give it a 1, and it returns a 2. Now, oftentimes your functions have optional arguments or default arguments or arguments that won't be set, and so inside your functions you often want defaults. So you could imagine that you might go var x equals, well, let's just set var x to 10. We'll go var y equals x, or if it's not x, we're going to set it to 1. So what is y? Y is 10, because x has a value. So let's go var u equals undefined, such that we know that u will mean undefined for this presentation. T will mean true, and we'll go f for false. So we got false, we got true, we got undefined. N equals null. Okay. So now if we want to set y to something, we could say, well, set it to n, or set it to false. Okay, so now what is y? Y is false. Now you're thinking, but you could just use the pipe, right? That's true. So let's just try it out. So I'm going to use the logical or to set it. What is y? Y is still false. That makes sense. But it's still the last value. But what if I want to set y to be false anyways as the argument, right? And maybe we've got another value. What is y? Y is empty string now. So that's kind of a problem. Logical or will take any value that's falsy and it will treat it as false, whereas the null coalescing operator will treat things that if they're null or undefined, it won't pass those on. So if we go var y equals, well, I can just go y equals f coalesce empty string, y is now false. So essentially what it's doing is it's saying, is it undefined or is it null? So we can go, is it null or false? And y is still false. We can go y equals, did I set true? Yeah. So we can go y equals nft. And in this case, it will give up once it hits f, because f is not undefined and f is not null. So it will return this as the value. So we can have a whole chain here. So now I'm using 3 null coalescing operators. So we can go y equals null, y or undefined, or false, or true. And it's still false. So that's pretty cool. So probably the best way to use this would be to use it to have default arguments if you didn't want to do it the ECMA 6 or the ECMAScript 2020 way. So an example would be function, and we're going to have it, this function is just basically going to be the log function, but it's going to have a default parameter. And we're going to go x is equal to this, or it's equal to 1.0. And then we're going to return math log x. Okay, so if I run log and I just go log, it returns 0 because math log 0 is that. Or, sorry, math log 1. So if it was undefined, what we'd find is we'd return a NaN. But instead it's saying, oh look, if x is not defined, as in I didn't provide it, so it's like I didn't even provide it, we'll set it to 1. But will it work when I give it a falsy value like 0? Yeah, it still works, and it gives me negative infinity, which is perfectly fine. It'll also work when I give it 0. We can give it an empty string, which shouldn't work, but it does. So, the null coalescing operator is really great for default arguments or arguments that you're going to set to null, but you want to set to null or undefined, but you want them to actually be set up. So, this can be pretty good when you've got like a collection, like it's got a collection like this, and then you want to grab something from it or give a default value. So you can use it to basically check your properties on your objects to make sure that they're not null or undefined. Now, it does work with null and undefined, so I don't think there's a non-null coalescing or just a purely undefined operator. But this is pretty useful. So default arguments and safety checks with default values is where you'd use the null coalescing operator. It's pretty new, so it'll work in the latest browsers, but you probably need to use something like Babel and polyfill in a version of the null coalescing operator. I hope this makes sense, and thank you for listening.